हेलो, आई एम ऑडिबल?
हेलो, कैन यू हियर मी?
यस, आई एम एबल टू हियर यू.
हाय अंजना, हाउ आर यू?
आई एम फाइन.
हाउ हैज योर सैटरडे बीन?
सैटरडे इज गुड एंड या That's amazing.
Great. It's been a long time since we last had a session, right?
Yes. 15 days back, I think.
So you took a break or you were trying out other tutors as well?
Yeah, I tried because you are not available. So I try with another tutor.
Yeah. No, you should always try other tutors. Keep trying, keep changing your tutors because yes. That helps you. Right. Okay. So let's just dig into the session.
Last Have you time gone you through said to me, you will give me some sentences. So I don't get it.
Yeah, you'll have to remind me because it's been such a long time. I don't clearly remember.
Hello.
And I've taken so many sessions. Actually, I was not available. I was, in fact, I changed my timings actually.
No, I'm said that last time you said me, you give me some sentences for the daily use, like 50 sentences, which I need to make video. So can you give me that sentences?
No, I had asked you to make them.
Okay. I was supposed that. Okay, I will.
Okay, now I got reminded. I had given you an exercise to basically form 50 simple sentences so that, wait a second, I think this light must be disturbing you, right? Right. No, actually, I had given you an exercise to basically form these simple 50 sentences so that you can become a little better in sentence formation.
Okay. I made some sentences and I practice also, but I have to make more sentences, like up to the 50. So I will definitely record that session, so it will be helpful for me.
Right. No. Good. If you keep practicing, that will definitely help you. Okay. Let's dig into the session itself.
Okay.
One second. Okay, you've gone through today's session document?
Yeah, I got gone through, not to very concentrate, but I go through approx.
Okay. So when you want to say that you have, seen the document not very carefully, you can say I have glanced.
Yeah, I have saw. Yeah, I have seen.
No. I'm telling you a new word, glance.
I was saw. Okay.
Glance.
Glance. Okay.
Right. Glance means not seeing it carefully.
Okay. Can you make some sentence so it will help us?
Can you?
For this word, can you make one sentence for me?
Yeah, I glanced through the document.
Okay.
Okay, glance through means that I didn't see it carefully.
Okay, I got it.
Okay, cool. Okay, so the topic of the day is session is conditional situations, which is one of my favorite topic because it's very interesting. It keeps you asking, some good questions.
Okay.
Are you connected? Your video has frozen.
I think your video is frozen to me.
Okay. Must be some bug. Anyway, cool. Let's just begin the session and I'll give you the tips at the end of the session. Okay.
Okay.
All right. What would you do if you could be invisible for a day?
If I were invisible for a day, so I want to travel to world because when I am not invisible, then I need some money. I need huge money. Like if I want to go abroad, so I need airplane ticket money huge. So definitely, I will. If I I will. If I were invisible, then I will go any place, and even I can sit over the airplane without any checking. And
Okay, that is one thing. Getting into the airplane or sneaking into the airplane. SNEAKING. Sneaking means, trying to get in without anybody knowing.
okay.
So when I say that I sneaked into the room, that means I went into the room without anybody knowing.
Okay,
I
silently.
sneaked.
I need whenever we go on any place where very
हाँ,
silently
तो छुप
without
करके
any.
घुसना, बेसिकली
हाँ,
छुप कर घुसना. हाउ यू
ओके,
सेड ना दैट यू वांट टू स्नीक इनटू एन एयरप्लेन विदाउट अ टिकट. छुप
या,
कर घुसना इज कॉल्ड स्नीकिंग.
ओके, आई गॉट इट.
ओके, गुड. ओके, कूल. दैट इज वन थिंग. व्हाट इज द अदर थिंग दैट यू वुड वांट टू डू इफ यू वर इनविजिबल?
If I will invisible, then I will if I were invisible, then I will try to a very expensive food which generally I'm not eating because they are very huge price.
So you would be okay. When you talk about any hypothetical situation, Anjana,
Okay.
we use the auxiliary would. We don't use will. So when you are saying if I were invisible, I will go to a restaurant. No, that is wrong. If I
No,
were
I was said
invisible.
that I wear WERE. I
Haha,
wear.
I wear is correct. If I
Okay.
were invisible, that is correct. But after that, when
Yes.
you're saying I will go to the restaurant, that instead of will, it should be would.
Okay.
Okay,
So
when we are talking about future hypothetical situations, we use would instead of will.
okay.
So if I were a bird, I would fly high. If I were not hungry right now, I would eat this cake. Okay, when we are talking about hypothetical future situations, would is what we use.
Okay,
Okay,
next time I
so
will
when
use.
you, yeah, so when you were saying, you should have said that if I were invisible, I would try the most expensive food in the world.
Okay.
Okay, cool. Which one will you do first? Will you first sneak into an airplane or would you first go and try something really exquisite?
I will try I would try for different variety of the food because it can be easily available and I have not much think about that. But for traveling, I have to think about where I have to plan for go and
Right.
like.
What would be one mischievous thing that you would do if you were invisible?
Mysterious. I will try to help the people which people have not money. Then I will try to take some money from the rich people and I will try to distribute with the poor. So that
Right.
will be mysterious. I will
So you
not
will be
prepare.
a Robin Hood.
I don't know about the Robin Hood, but definitely
Okay.
I will
Okay,
do
since you have
like that.
anyway brought up giving away the money, let's say you are not invisible, but you are suddenly rich. Okay, you have a lot of money
Okay.
to give away also. Who would you help and how?
When I become rich, so I want to invest my money in education field. So I will work on the
Not I will, I
children.
would.
I would be work on the children which have not privilege for the good education. So indirectly they will be the they will be make the world a bit a better place.
Right, absolutely. So you want to work on the roots.
Yeah, I want to work on the root. I would like to work on the root.
Right. Okay. Let's say if you could commit one crime and get away with it, what would you do?
I want to if somebody in past very upset me, in the past somebody was upset me, then I want to take revenge of that person. and that sentence judge will not punish me because I have one.
Right. Okay. So with that, we have completed the document. Okay. Do go through. Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, I'm able to hear you.
Okay. So what I'm saying is that after the session, do try going through the session document and do try the grammar exercises that are given in there.
Yeah, I tried. I tried I have to read. Right. I have something like sentences perfect, past perfect. So I tried and learned, and even I do the exercise of that section. There is one section where we need to correct, I have read as something like error was, then I corrected it.
Okay, good. It's good that you try these exercises. It's a great thing that will definitely help you. Coming to this session's feedback, the number one thing that I want to tell you is that you have definitely, definitely improved a lot. Last time I remember when we had met, you were forming a lot of wrong sentences, which is why I gave you that exercise, right, of sentence formations.
Yeah. You remind me that your sentence forming is not correct. So I gone through the tenses and I watched the TED Talk videos, how the sentences a narrator will pick up, how the even I read some books. So I watch out which is the correct way after saying the same sentence.
Right. So definitely that has helped. You are not forming a lot of wrong sentences now. Mostly they are correct. Now what I want you to do is that definitely once or twice a week, do try the sentence formation exercise, because that helps you in understanding it, that helps you training your brain to form correct sentences more often. Apart from that,
mostly I feel difficulty in past. In even when we make some sentence like past, and even one condition came in past, we have to describe something.
So good. It's good that you know where your problem lies. So what you should do is form past tense sentences, right? Because you know that you have a little bit of problem there. So when you're forming these sentences, form them in past tense. Also, I want you to work on 10 to 15 would sentences. What are the would sentences? Basically, you have to make condition and then you have to write a sentence. For example, your sentences will be like this. If I were the prime minister, I would reduce the petrol's price. If I were not going to Goa, I would have come to your place, right?
Yeah.
So sentences like these, where you form, where there's a condition, future condition, where would will be. Okay, why am I giving you this? Is because I want you to be comfortable with would. What we have seen in today's session is that you are not very comfortable with would. There is a small video in Clappingo app on would, could, should. You should watch that. It's just 2 minutes video. You can watch it whenever you want. And that will definitely help you.
Yeah. Thanks for precious suggestion. Your suggestion is really helpful to me.
Right. Thank you so much. Do you have any other doubts, any concerns you want to ask? We have come to the end of the session.
Okay. I have not presently doubt. I have only the doubt with the past sentences.
So do form those sentences. That will definitely help you. And keep watching English content as you are, right? Watching TED Talks and all that will definitely help. Okay?
Yeah. Definitely.
Okay, it was really nice talking to you, Anjana.
Thank you.
After so long, it was really nice. Thank you so much. See you. Good day.
Thank you. Bye bye. We see you. May have a day. Bye-bye. Good day.
Yeah.